yourself, how does it feel to win the Euro Cup for the first time in your career?
I mean, it feels amazing. You know, I won some things in my life, but winning a European Championship, there is nothing like it.
What was the key to win this game?
Defense. You know, I live by defense and I die by defense. So that was the key all along. We want to play our game in our home, and we did it.
How are you going to celebrate?
I don't know yet, but it's going to be hard.
Thank you very much.
It's kind of Americanized, but it's different. The rules and culture are different. I mean, I think Athens so far has been the most relaxing spot to get adjusted to. I mean, the people are great. The organization is wonderful. Everything is going smoothly.
This season, he has contributed greatly to the success of the Greens, averaging a performance index rating of just under 12, which is higher than 14 in the top 16 alone. The icing on the cake came against arch-rivals Olympiakos Piraeus, where he managed an index rating of 25, which was also important because it helped the team win.
I mean, if you play for Panathinaikos, you don't really have time to think about index performing. Small, they put a big accent on team basketball. But, you know, knowing that I played good that game personally and also to beat Olympiakos at home with our fans was a really good feeling.
When Stefan is on the floor, everybody gets excited because they know there are some big blocks in store.
Timing, because, you know, I used to think it's because, I mean, when I was a little younger, I used to think it was because I jump high, but I usually don't go get them up there. I time it.
Blocking is something he especially likes.
I feel great. I mean, it's a confidence booster for me, for the team. You know, it gives us energy. And, you know, we live for that. We want little plays that give us energy so we can just push a little bit more.
And there is a second reason why the crowd loves him, this time at the other end of the floor. However, here he needs a little bit of help.
For that little half a second that you're in the air, you know, you feel really great. And especially when you have a passer like Diamantidis, when you jump, you know, the pass is just so perfect that you actually feel like for a second you fly a little bit.
But of the two, Stefan has no doubts about what he prefers and what is best for the team.
Block, man. Block, you know, you feel like you have a bigger impact than the dunk. Dunks happen. You know, a lot of players can dunk, but a block, especially if it's a big stop or at a certain point in the game where you really need it, it feels great. It feels great for the team, especially.
Few basketball stars have come further from more unlikely beginnings than Stefan Lazmir of Anadolu Efes Istanbul. The EuroLeague's third best shot blocker ever started life on the west coast of Africa, Impojanti, which despite being Gabon's second largest city, is so remote that it's only accessible by airplane.
I mean, I'll say it's a very laid-back city. Everything is kind of slow.
Basketball was such an afterthought in Port-Gentil that Lazmir had to sneak out of his house late at night just to see games on TV. His parents wanted him to get an education, and he found a way to do that through basketball, emigrating to the United States after high school.
All along, I was just trying to use basketball as a way to get a better education. I didn't really think about being a professional until people really started talking about it in my senior year in college. Even in Gabon, I was just thinking that I was going to use basketball to just get a degree somewhere.
The jumping ability that makes him a great shot blocker might be traced to the basket that Lazmir built, 10 centimeters higher than normal, when he was a kid in Gabon. But the notion that he might someday be like those players he watched on TV was as far away as Port-Gentil itself.
I couldn't imagine, but I could only dream, you know. I was young and I didn't know where basketball was going to take me, but all I kept doing is dreaming about playing professional somewhere.
Despite being so isolated, Port-Gentil was once considered the world's most expensive city due to the oil industry's large presence there. That's just another part of the special character of Port-Gentil, according to the city's other best-known export.
It's expensive mostly because of the oil companies and stuff. And I mean, people have to make a living over there. But I said everything is slow. It's the water, but the ocean, a lot of wildlife. I mean, you love it.
In addition to his shot blocking prowess, which earned him the Best Defender Trophy in 2013, Lazmir has been known among his four EuroLeague teams, Partizan Belgrade, Maccabi Electra Tel Aviv, Panathinaikos Athens, and now Efes, for his sense of humor. An attribute he credits to his upbringing in Port-Gentil.
When you don't have much, you find a way to entertain yourself, and most people just are jokers over there. You have to be ready to joke about people or to get joked on. So, it's a good way to pass the time.
Lazmir's life is not all fun and games, though. In the off-season, he often returns to Gabon to carry out charity work with local children, an initiative that resulted last summer in an unexpected meeting with the country's president.
I went to Gabon for the summer just to take care of some charity stuff. And I guess because it wasn't a little mediatized, I got a phone call from the presidential cabinet, and they said the president wanted me to meet me just to thank me for what I'm doing for the country. The fact that I'm playing basketball in a high level is a good thing for the country, and we just got to talk about sports and the things to do in our country.
This summer, Lazmir will again represent Gabon at the African Championships in August after his national team's qualification for the first time in a decade. As Gabon's only professional basketball export, he is conscious of the elevated status he enjoys in his home country.
It took a while for people to catch on, but media is kind of slow over there, I say. And people don't spend time in looking. They don't have a big culture of sports, I say. So, it took a while, but nowadays
because more and more news about me over the Ngabwani people realize and to pay attention more to the games.
And with that status comes responsibility. Even though Lazmi is far away from his faraway hometown for the largest part of every year.
Hearing the kids talking about me, asking me how I did it, tell me that I'm kind of a role model for them. That's when I realized the stuff that I do in basketball is important for them, for the kids, I mean for Gabon.